experiencing it.
Epilepsy surgery is still the most definitive way to cure epilepsy.
Patients in whom there's a potential for some type of surgical procedure to help them will have gone through a comprehensive evaluation under the direction of our epilepsy neurologist.
In order to do a very successful surgery, you need to know exactly what you're going to cut, but more importantly, what not to cut, because we want to make patients seizure-free, but at the same time, we don't want them to lose their ability to talk, to walk, or to think.
We have the best possible imaging, including all the way up to so-called 7 Tesla. This shows details of the brain that you can't see with other types of images, although it's still experimental. We have metabolic studies of the brain. We have the highest level of video EEG monitoring.
So alternating polarity per second pulse width.
We use the most advanced possible mapping techniques. What my colleague, Dr. Parvizi, does is listen into the chatter of individual or very small groups of neurons.
How about now?
As they go about their normal business, to be able to tell how were those disrupted during a seizure, and perhaps more importantly, what price will be paid for removing that piece of brain.
This is called functional mapping of the brain. We implant these spying microphones over the surface of the brain, and we just listen to the waves of the brain and signals generated in the brain and understand how the brain areas are communicating with each other.
Open your eyes.
Dr. Parvizi and his colleagues have developed methods to do that, which can take place in a comfortable, spontaneously awake patient. During normal waking activity, what's happening to the brain cells when the person's reading? What's happening when they're searching for a word?
Starting to feel like I might have a seizure.
If I am very close by the seizure zone, tickling that area is going to actually give the patient the sensation of, oh, now you're touching my seizure area, now I'm feeling my seizures coming. That's a good way for us to determine exactly where to go.
After we've determined where the seizures are coming from, we will do an open operation where we will go in and take out that part of the brain, especially if we've determined that's a safe area to take out.
What is really unique about Stanford Epilepsy Program is that by combining science and clinical practice, we can actually do more effective operations on patients and help them become seizure-free and at the same time keep their vital functions.